Hello everyone and welcome to the Microsoft Security Update Summary, where I will present a short recap of what was released today, April 8th, 2025. My name is Josh Daniel and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. I'm going to start this video with an overview of the release and then I'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities I'm covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months and see how it stacks up. There are 123 newly disclosed vulnerabilities in this release. Of those, 31 fall into the remote code execution impact. That's a little bit lower than average over the past 13 months, where we've been averaging just over 36. Next, I'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 0 and 10, where 10 represents the highest level of risk. We have an average of around 9.5 for that high water mark. This month, the highest scored CVE in today's set comes in at 8.8. The average score across the entire release of all the vulnerabilities comes in at 7.41, which is about a tenth of a point lower than our average over the past 13 months. There are no publicly disclosed vulnerabilities in today's set. We've been averaging just over 2, and there is one vulnerability that was known to be exploited at the time of release. We've been averaging a little over 2 per month over the past 13 months. All right, next we'll move into just this release and we'll start with an overview of this release. Those of you familiar with this video, you'll recognize where we put the Windows products towards the bottom and then we move up into things like Office and then other products that are not necessarily serviced every single month. That's certainly the case here. With the Windows, as we can see this month, we're ranging between a little over 80 vulnerabilities per month on Windows Server 2025 and then down to just under 60 vulnerabilities on a couple of the Windows 10 products. So we continue moving up the chart, we get into Office and SharePoint, we get into some developer tools such as ASP.NET, Visual Studio, those have a handful of vulnerabilities with those. System Center has a vulnerability this month, Microsoft Dynamics 365 Business Central has a vulnerability that's being addressed, and rounding it all out, we have SQL Server Management Studio that has a vulnerability that needs to be addressed. SQL Server itself does not have an update this month. It's only the Management Studio that has a vulnerability that's being addressed this month and will need you to update the SSMS. Okay, let's dive into a few of the vulnerabilities from today's release. The first one I'll talk to is CVE-2025-29824. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability in the Common Log File System, or CLFS. This one is important severity, privately disclosed, but exploitation has been detected prior to release. The CVSS base score is 7.8 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is local, the attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. An attacker that was able to successfully leverage this would be able to gain system privileges. There are no mitigations or documented workarounds. As far as the affected software, it's all versions of Windows that is in mainstream support, whether that's Windows 10 and 11 on desktop, or Server 2016, 2019, 2022, or Server 2025 on the server side. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2025-27740. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This is in the Active Directory Certificate Services, or ADCS. This has a CVSS base score of 8.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required, but no user interaction is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds, and it only affects the server versions of Windows, Server 2016, 2019, 2022, and 2025. Right, next I'll talk to CVE-2025-26647. This is an important severity elevation of privilege vulnerability in Kerberos. This was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a CVSS base score of 8.1 on that scale of 10. The attack vectors over the network. The attack complexity is high. No privileges are required, and no user interaction is required on this. Now, there's no documented mitigations or workarounds on this, but there is a unique deployment plan here. Specifically, there are three steps, each with its own separate date. There's the update state, which is the state we're in now, and then followed by monitoring for new events, and then finally, full enablement. So right now, as of April 8th, by default, these mitigations are not enabled. So if you want to enable protections for this vulnerability, you will need to update a registry key to be fully protected from this. Starting July 8th, this vulnerability will be enforced by default. And then in October, full enforcement mode will be pushed on all versions of Windows. So that October 14th security update will be full enforcement with no opting out. So again, to go over the stages, we are right now in the first stage where the update has become available and customers can enable this mitigation. In July, this will be enforced by default. And in October, the ability to disable protections here will be removed. There's more information in a KB article. It's linked down there at the bottom, KB5057784. It's also linked in the CVE article itself that talks in more detail about what those timeline of changes are, as well as the registry keys that you'll need to be looking at. Okay, so the final vulnerability that I'll talk to today, we'll move out of Windows and we'll move into Office with a SharePoint vulnerability. This is CVE-2025-29794. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability, rated 8.8 on a CVSS scale. The attack vectors over the network, the attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required. No user interaction is required to leverage this. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this. And as far as the affected software, it's SharePoint Subscription Edition, SharePoint 2019, and SharePoint Enterprise 2016. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer, and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your CSAM to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub under the newsletters and search for security briefing and select your region and language. All right, I want to thank everyone for watching today, and I will talk to you all next month.